Hi everyone, the Lone Wolf here. Welcome back to EVE Talk, your weekly look at the market in EVE Online. And we know now from the latest scope video that the Hecate is coming in the next release, and it looks like a pretty awesome brawling destroyer. We also learned in that video that the Galente actually speak with a bit of a French accent. So I thought it was pretty funny. It was immediately picked up on the in the comments and on Reddit as well. I thought calling the Hecate the horizontal baguette was kind of funny as well. That was interesting that CCP would use such a strong French accent in that video for a Galente announcement. Anyways, we are here for the market, so let's jump right in with Plex, and that would be at, let me see, where the hell am I looking here, 50 seconds. And 30-day pilot license, as you can see, going up 840 million for the sellers. And the bad news is that the buyers are following suit, 921 to 940 for the sellers. So if we go to the chart, you can clearly see that we're still climbing. And right here at the 800 million mark is where I bought a few. So that is good news. How high can this go? I don't know. But I'm starting to get the feeling that I may want to unload if I want to secure some profits at this point. Still, that's a pretty impressive rise. Pretty much straight up once again. And so we never know when this is actually going to end. One thing that could be an indication, now that I'm thinking about it, I'm always going back to what we experienced previously, of course. That's pretty much the background that I have. And during every winter release, there would be a sharp drop-off after a while. I mean, there would be a final spike and then a sharp drop-off. And the next release will actually be a pretty big shake-up with the Entosis Link starting to play its role in sovereignty. I do think that there could be a mirror effect there, where we could see a last sprint upwards as the release approaches, and that after that actually we could start to slow down on EVE Online after the newness of the Entosis Link used for sovereignty will wear off. There, that should be like in the middle of the summer, there we could actually see a real pullback in Plex. That is, of course, if I'm right in seeing the next release actually a big one, that the community is gambling on a little bit and thus causing partly this increase in price. If of course this is the skins doing, if this is FanFest and possibly other things like the tournament as well, if all of these are effects like that, it's going to be very hard to say if or when we're going to actually see a pullback for Plex. But yeah, the increase in price is quite noticeable, and we're slowly closing in on a billion for Plex, which of course would make earning those in-game quite a bit of a challenge. Let's take a look at the multiple pilot certificates. Here we can see that one is also trending up pretty much since April as well. Someone was actually nice enough to send me the explanation for this really big dip right here. Turns out that there was some sort of sale that you could get these for like 10% of the price or something like that for real life money for these multiple pilot training certificates. And so everyone just started buying those very, very cheaply and then dumping them on the market, because the conversion of real life money to ISK compared to a Plex or anything else was just so much better when they had, I don't know, it's like 90% off of the price or something like that. And so that's what caused this huge drop here, but it's already recovering. So it must have like been caught or something, or it only lasted a day or something like that. But that's the explanation for this huge drop right here. It was actually a real life sale. And then next up we've got the pilot bodies rescope. That one is still not going up in trend with the other two, and so we could say that this market, the pilot's body rescope certificate, is actually disconnected from Plexus, who unfortunately are now going for 940 million. That's bad news for people that want to Plex their accounts. Good news for people that invested on this seeing it now low point of 800 million. So there you go, Plex market. We're heading into expensive territory once again. Next up, we'll check the minerals, and that would be at 450. Let's take a look here at Tritanium, which has been going down a little bit in the last few weeks here as well. It tried to hold on at 5:30, but it really doesn't look like that's going to work anymore. As you can see, definitely going down in the at the end of the chart there. In fact, the difference between the 5-day moving average and the 20-day moving average is just widening, which I do think means that this decrease in price has some momentum. Look out for 5 ISK, I think 5:10 for the buyers, 5:15 for the sellers. Demand here, billion, but this is actually like more than a day old, so it's been there for a bit as well. Here we've got one for 2 billion that wants to buy at 486, and that's pretty recent, so I do think that there are other people expecting a further decrease in the price of Isaac Minerals. Supply wise, 1.5 billion, 900 million. You'd still think that there's more demand, thus providing some pressure on the price to go back up, but these are all, well, here 5:10, that does put a bit of a floor on it. But other than that, the next big order is really very ambitious, 486 right there. I may want to jump in just before that or something like that. So pressure is on for Tritanium at least. Let's take a look at the pyrite chart here. Well, that one was actually pretty much crashing down to breaking 1080, and it bounced off of that. And then it's going to be interesting. Maybe I should quickly grab the 1 month chart here. It's going to be interesting to see what happens right here. Is the 5-day moving average going to cross the 20-day moving average, or is that going to start going back down once again? Depending on that, I think chances are good that it is just a 10.8 price mark that basically said, okay, right here I've got a couple people with big buy orders, and thus causing the price to jump back up, but that it could actually go back down after this. 1088 for the buyers, 1098 for the sellers, very small margin. The demand here is in the 20 to 40 million mark. One big one for 187 million, but as you can see, that's below the 10.8 mark there, where it actually bounced off. So maybe this 32 million here, well, that's a new one. This is an older one, 10 million, but all of these are too small. Look at this supply here, 600 million, 900 million, 357 million. I would say that, yeah, this is actually going to start correcting back down, and that we won't break the 20-day moving average in the pyrite market. So Isaac Minerals, yeah, not doing too hot at the moment. Here is the Mexalon chart, pretty much a mirror of the Tritanium one, where we can see the 5-day moving average going down much faster than 20-day moving average. So it has some momentum. We're approaching 42 ISK, 42.40 for the sellers, 42.13 for the buyers, and still we have 230 million, 150 million, which are by far the biggest order very recent on the seller side. So at the moment, people are selling like crazy, so I'm going to continue investing my own ISK in some of these I think cheap minerals. Next up, we've got Isogen here, exactly the same once again, approaching 100 ISK on Isogen, 101.88 for the buyers, 100.14 for the sellers. I actually bought some at 100 already, but I think if you wait it out a little bit, you could start buying Isogen below 100 ISK. That pressure is on. Still, we've got 16 million units coming in here, 9 million units coming in here. Look at the buy orders. Everyone is very careful, and they know that the prices are going down at the moment when it comes to the buyers for all of these. So very interesting situation. I thought that we would have a longer stable period for Isaac Minerals, but no, those are clearly going down now. Let's take a look at Noxium as well. That one is very good, going down quite steeply as well in the last week or so. If you compare, let's take the 1 month chart here once again. If you compare its movement in the last few days to the 20-day moving average right here, definitely going down substantially. Let's take a look at the sellers and buyers. 510 for the sellers, 497 for the buyers, below 500 ISK once again, and still we have here 3.72 million, 2 million. It's only the more ambitious orders at 497.03, sorry, which is not even in the station, that's bigger than that. We have to go as low as 496.90 for a big buy order. So the pressure is still on. I think you can actually pick up Noxium below 500 ISK already. And on the 1 year chart, as you can see, I think that's not a bad price. So I'm actually going to invest a little bit in Noxium as well after doing Eve Talk. I'm just going to buy some more minerals. I actually think these could be pretty good investments considering their downtrend right here. Let's take a look then at the Nausicaä ones. These are actually doing a lot better. Let's start with Zydrine, which is going up a little bit, breaking 1400 ISK here, 1488.9 for the sellers, 1390 for the buyers. So these are still very much in demand and still going up in price. And then over here we've got Megasite, which is doing the same. In fact, this is kind of unusual right here. You could see that we were below 20-day moving average, causing a little bit of a price drop. Then going above that here, I thought we would once again go below, you know, have a bit of normal market variation, normal market action going on in a sideways movement. But now we're actually tracking that back up, and we're actually above, or still pretty much above, the 20-day moving average. Currently, Megasite selling for 21.28 pretty much, and there is a big number coming in here, so that could be good news. But 20.71 for the buyers. They're actually willing to follow suit, and it's really the sellers that are dictating the market here at the moment, and that price is still going up quite a bit. So Nausicaä minerals, they're still very hot at the moment, and still managing to maintain a pretty high price historically speaking, due to the changes that CCP Fosse introduced there. Let's touch on Morphite, which is actually used in Take-Two stuff. A nice spike correction, but the trend is still up, very much up. In fact, this is a 3-month chart. Let's go for a 6-month chart. You can see it stayed just below 6,000 ISK for most of these 6 months. If I go for the 3-month chart, up to 12,000, a doubling in price in these 3 months. And in fact, most of the momentum has actually been in like the last month or so. And we're looking at 11,700 ISK for Morphite, 11,000 at least for the buyers. And here again, I do think it's the sellers that are dictating the price at the moment. So here they were a bit overly ambitious. Some people did decide to dump a lot of stocks at around 14,000, but we are still trending up. The 20-day moving average is about to be crossed once again. That does mean that Morphite, I think, still has some momentum. So yeah, the minerals for the Nausicaä miners, their profits are going up quite substantially. Hysek miners, really not the time to be mining and selling to the market immediately. I think if I do some mining, I would try to hold on to the minerals for better times. Next up, the Take One market, 1240. For that, let's take a look at the impact here. Apocalypse still a little bit higher here, currently going for 182. It's not dramatic though, but we are seeing that for the Apocalypse at least, a new normal price pretty much of 180. You could have put that a little bit below that, but still 178, 176, it's not really a big difference, but a very slight uptrend over 6 months. I am starting to see that in the Apocalypse here. The question is, will this actually be able to maintain, or, you know, are we going to go back down here? Is this due to supply demand? Let's take a quick look here. 53 Apocalypse is coming in here very recently, trying to sell at 183. So I do think that there's actually some pressure on this, and that this is considered a high price for Apocalypse, and this could correct back down a little bit very soon. Overall, I think that the Take One market is still very healthy and staying decently stable. Here is the Caracaldo working on 1, 2, 3, 4, well, definitely 3 significant spikes in the last 6 months here, now going for above 12 million, 12.4 for the sellers, 11.7 for the buyers, and 20-day moving average is being pulled up here once again as well. So the Caracal definitely in vogue at the moment. This could be due to missile changes that are coming as well, that people are actually investing in the Caracal, which is already something that's used a lot in Nausicaä and could become even better if we get better modules that support the missile playstyle. And of course, if we look at it, despite its really long nose, it does look pretty damn cool, the Caracal. Here's the Dominix then. That one is finally coming back down to a more normal price of 190. Maybe all of the drone changes are starting to hurt the Dominix a little bit. You know, the drone meta could be coming out of vogue, And we were talking 195 for the sellers, 185, 186 for the buyers, 190 right in between there. You could easily pick up a Dominix for 190 at the moment, which is the same as you could like 6 months ago. So at least so far, the mineral changes doesn't seem to have had that big of an impact on the Dominix market. Here is the Myrmidon then. This is similar. We started at 53.5, we're ending right in there once again. So over these 6 months, the Myrmidon has not actually changed in price, presumably in cost not that much either, except for this double spike right here, which of course can be someone saying, okay, well, I'll try a Myrmidon fleet, I'm buying pretty much all of them, or on speculation. Although honestly, if you look at the numbers here, this is a pretty big market to manipulate at more than 50 million a piece, and well, pretty much, well, actually I was gonna say hundreds of them on the market, but it's not hundreds of them, so this could actually be manipulated for players with very big wallets. But the supply is pretty healthy here, even at 54 million, and demand is decently robust as well. We have some new orders coming in with 943, so this is all looking quite okay. Here's a Stabber that was actually going up quite substantially. It's finally correcting back down towards 11 million. Now, it used to be closer to 10 million, so the question is, are we going to back down that low? 10.3 and, well, 10.9 for the sellers right here. It is trying, it is trying. So it could be interesting if we actually see this come back down even further, and if the 5-day moving average could end up below the 10.5 million mark, then we could say that the Stabber has done something very similar to what we just saw for the Myrmidon and the Dominix. 6 months with no actual difference at those two extremes, but some movement of course in between there. Keep in mind as well, everything pretty much on this chart is between the 10 and the 12 million mark, so that's not that huge of a difference up or down from the average of 11 either. So not that big a deal, despite the fact that this chart does look pretty violent, and you can see here big volume together with the spike, so it has a reason as well. Next up, the Tornado. That one is settling higher, so started at, I would say, 66 million on average in the first 4 months, and now clearly it is settling at 72 million. Supply demand here, demand 66 million, well, which is actually right on the old normal, I would have put, but sellers, they're coming in at 73 million. Supply is starting to come in though, so here once again I'm seeing pressure here on the supply side because of the price of 73 million. Could this start to go back down, and will we once again see Tornadoes bit closer to 66 million on average? I think it's still possible, but the buyers have followed suit though. They are upping the price just a little bit. That pressure is on apparently, so it could be that the Tornado is going to settle a bit higher, just like the Apocalypse did. And then finally, the Vexor, not the Galente ship. If we take the 20-day moving average, maybe this is clearly a spike that we're coming off of, starting at 1120, ending at 1120 again. The Galente ships seem to have gone up a little bit in price, with quite some volatility as well, in starting April with the mineral changes, but they're now all settling back on their price point of 6 months ago, which I think means that the Tech One ship market is very mature. It knows what it's doing. There's plenty of supply, there's plenty of demand as well. It's just a machine that's running very nicely, managing to maintain a price that we've been enjoying for like a year or so, I would say, or even more. Next up, Tech 2 market for some trades. Let's take a look at that. 1840 for that. I think a lot of them were up last week, and now of course the Basilisk is contracting back, so sell opportunity is over. Try to once again spot buy opportunities, maybe close to 170 or something like that. But it's good to see that the Basilisk was alive last week. Here's the Guardian then. That one is actually trending up. You could have bought them close to 115, 120 for sure, and now we're actually going 135, and it looks like the market is actually settling there a little bit, which is interesting. It could go either way. Someone comes in and says, okay, I need more Guardians for another fleet. Then we could see a spike up. All of a sudden people saying, okay, 135 for Guardians, let's start making them, bring them to the market, we could actually go back down. 120 for investing in Guardians seems like a very good idea, which is what I did, and then I actually sold them close to the current price. Next up, the Hound here, 17 million, going back down a little bit. I'd wait it out, honestly. The Hound has not known any really major movements, and I think I'm still stuck with the ones I bought, although I did buy them close to this bottom right here. We have to wait, I think, for stealth bombers to come back in vogue. They're taking a bit of a hit with the fleet warp changes as well, so stealth bomber fleets will become a bit more tricky, which could decrease demand once again, so be very careful. The Manticore, on the other hand, the one I don't like personally because it's still way above 20 million, has done a nice move here, big spike up. So you could have bought them close to 21, you can sell them for 25 at the moment. That's not bad at all, and does show that even the Manticore market is still very much alive. I do love these spikes. Here is the Nemesis, that's great. You could have bought them for 18, and the top here was at 22, so 4 million on an 18 million investment. That's not bad percentage wise. Of course, it is coming down now, so you should have sold last week if you invested, which honestly, it was more luck than skill, I have to be honest. But like 2 weeks ago, I did move on the Nemesis. I bought 8 right here, I think, close to this point, or maybe close to this point. And then I did sell them towards 20 million, I think, on this rise up here. So it was a good opportunity, and I was a bit lucky. I made some money. Next up, the Oneiros here. Once again, we do see it coming off of a spike, which is really good. But buying, you know, if you could buy close to 140, considering the chart right here, that would be very good for an Oneiros. And then here we've got the Purifier chart. That one is actually going up in a more sustained manner. Very interesting. I really did buy right here on that very low point because it stayed there for so long. Considering the rest of the chart, it was the time to buy, and it turns out that it was. I may have sold a bit too early, although I do think I sold close to 19 million for the Purifier. So I think I made a good move, and now honestly it's a bit time to start to find another opportunity to spend some money in here. All of these now are neither at the bottoms nor at their tops anymore, so the opportunity is over a little bit. The volatility is gone for a while, and now it's a matter of finding out the next opportunities. Here again, the Scimitar, decent double spike starting well close to 115, heading up to 135, almost 130, 135, back down to 120 again, back up again. So if this pattern continues, I think we could be in for some interesting weeks in the tech tool market where some money could be made, but it's true that you have to wait for the right opportunity to actually buy them, which for like the Nemesis here, that was pretty clear. And then definitely the Purifier right there, I did spot that buy opportunity, and I took advantage of that. So yeah, let's keep an eye on the tech 2 market, and if I spot any, I'll definitely let you know. Next up, tech 3 market, that is at 22.45. I think that last week the Tengu did know a bit of a jump up of 10%, but it's already correcting back. If you've seen the ticker right here, the Confessor though, let's start with these tech 3 destroyers. They're very new, and so people have been jumping on them quite a bit, but so have the production side of things. As you can see right here, huge numbers of supply, meaning that the price is just very stable and probably very close to production cost. So 34.5 million for the sellers, 33 almost for the buyers. Very, very small margin, and very stable at the moment. Here is the Jackdaw then, and that one is already going down. Its high point is only 80 million, which is really not that much. And it's already 38 for the sellers, 35 for the buyers. I mean, these are affordable prices. You would say that that's a normal price for the Jackdaw, and just go use it and lose it. And then the Zwiepel here, 36 for the sellers, 32 for the buyers, and as you can see, it's working on a similar chart to the Confessor. Although the Confessor, I mean, that one is just straight down and then never broke 50 million again, just straight down right at the start. Of course, it does start from 300 million and even higher. Then we've got the Zwiepel was next, I think. Well, actually, that one only starts at like 875 to 80 million, so very similar to the Jackdaw here. But again, they're always going straight down and then stabilizing very quickly. I think that's just especially the new ones, because well, everyone knew what to gather, what to prepare for once the Confessor had its run. So there you go, that's the destroyers. Let's take a look at the cruiser charts here. The Legion breaking out quite nicely, actually. So starting at 140, we're now looking at 170. Yeah, 178 for the sellers, 158 for the buyers. It's interesting to see that there are these big moves on tech tree fleets. I think at some point people are maybe expecting these to be rebalanced a little bit. That should come. I mean, a lot of the other ships have already been rebalanced. Some have even had a second pass. At some point, CCP is going to make their move on the tech tree ships, and then we're really going to probably see a very big move on them. So this could be just investors and Nelsic Alliances investing in tech tree fleets just to be sure that they have them and that they can pick them up at cheap prices. You can see once again 140 seems to have been a trigger, and people came in, bought a lot of them, causing this price spike. But I do think that the supply is still there, and thus that all of these spikes until CCP comes out with a change will be short-lived and will correct very quickly. Here's the Loki then, try to break out, but stuck at 160. And are we going back down already? Yeah, 158 and a half. You can see here 10, 10, 10, 11, 8, 5, 5. And starting here. So these sell orders are all very recent, less than 24 hours old. And all of them again competing with each other, bringing that pressure back on the Loki price right here. Demand is pretty healthy though. So look at that. A lot of very recent buy orders, but they're much smaller in scale, of course. Next up here, we've got the Proteus. Again, also trying to hold on at 160. Let's see if the supply numbers are coming in. Oh, not that much. This is recent, this is recent, and this is recent, but they're not that big. So there is a little bit of a gap here at the moment, or maybe a lull in production for some reason. Could be the Jackdaws doing, because those numbers are absolutely huge. And if there's any margin, it's bound to be the Jackdaw at the moment, of course. So that could be the reason why the cruisers know a bit of a better time here. 156 for the Tengu, 150 for the for the buyers, and as you can see right here, did try to go up to 160, but now 5-day moving average crossing the 20-day moving average. Is the pressure back on in the numbers here as well? Not that much, 12. But the entire front page here though is recent. It's less than 24 hours old. So yeah, people came back on the Tengu because that one has been going up for a little bit. You can see that the supply is coming back, thus putting pressure on the price. And I think in a few weeks we'll see the exact same for the Allegiant, the Loki, and the Proteus. So pressure is on, but keep that in mind. At some point, CCP will do a rebalance of tech tree ships, and it could be a very good investment, just like what we saw. You never know what CCP does, and if you want something like what the Zydra did right here, then at some point the tech tree ships are going to have a rebalance because all of their niches are being taken by other ships. I mean, Bubble Immunity went to Interceptors, the covered ops, people can do that. They want to get them off grid for boosters. They want to kill that as well. So all of their users have slowly been killed off or are expected to be killed off, and so they need to find something new for the tech tree cruisers. At some point they'll come up with something, and then where that market is going, it could be a worthy gamble if you ask me. And then finally, for the extra product, I wanted to check out the Gecko. I actually saw it in the market discussions on the forums. We will take 28-20 for that, and it's one of those really interesting ones, a very unique item, of course, the Gecko drone, because at the moment we can't make more of them, and they're just so good that people do want to use them, actually use them. And so here is the 1-year chart. They started off at 15 million, and at the moment they're already worth 65 million. So that's 67 million for the sellers, 64 for the buyers. So very interesting on this chart, I feel, is how they constantly have like this spike up. And I think that could be related to like really big losses. All of a sudden someone loses a carrier that was full of geckos or something like that. That was using them a little bit too much, and thus you get this really big jump up. But this is a very unique item in with the fact that you can't produce any more of them. Still, keep one thing in mind. You know, I read in that market discussion when it comes to the Gecko, the correct sentence is that as long as CCP doesn't add more to the game, these will only increase in value, because every Gecko that is destroyed in the game, and they're destroyed on a regular basis. They're used quite a bit because they're simply the best drone and so unique. As long as that doesn't happen, as long as CCP doesn't add geckos to the game, once again, this price is only going to go up, their value is only going to go up. But it also said that they don't think it's gonna happen. Well, there was this unique implant for the collector's edition, and they came out with new implants. They gave them to everyone. That value completely disappeared, and I never took advantage of that. So that was like, I don't know, 1.8 billion or something like that that I could have had in the wallet, and now I actually have a worthless implant. Keep that in mind. At some point, you know, maybe these new heavy attack drones could become a part of the structure arsenal. You know, there are many scenarios where all of a sudden CCP could decide that, well, we're actually going to make heavy attack drones. They're going to be producible by the players, and then of course the Gecko is going to probably drop in value quite substantially all of a sudden. So keep that in mind if the Gecko is the market you're actually making your move on, the investment you want to make. You never know, I can see plenty of scenarios where this value could actually be destroyed by CCP, and it happened to other products. So don't think that, oh well, this was a unique gift and they love this. Well, at some point, you know, heavy attack drones, they're just the best out there, they're useful. I can actually see CCP deciding that, well, we're actually gonna make more of these, and we're gonna make them producible by the player base. So this is of course an investment that at the moment is very good at retaining its value and even increasing its value, probably even better than Plex, I would say, just because, well, they get destroyed, they're gone, there's no more of them coming back into the game. But there is a risk attached to that, and that risk, if it does hit, it's gutting. I mean, it completely destroys all of the value all of a sudden. So keep that in mind when you think about maybe investing in the Gecko. Anyways, that's it for this Eve Talk, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you all next time.